Have you ever once asked yourself the question, what is matter really made of? Today, I will be discussing the standard model, a physical model conceived to address the very question. Matter at a very basic level is made up of elementary particles which have no volume. The masses and energies are related by Einstein's formula. However, such particles only matter at the quantum mechanical level. The standard model consists of matter particles called fermions and interaction particles called bosons. Fermions obey the Pauli exclusion principle, which states that no two fermions can exist with certain identical properties. Fermions are either quarks or leptons and are divided into three generations. The first generation is the most stable and thus is the most commonly observed. The standard model includes three types of interactions: strong, electromagnetic, and weak. These forces are mediated by vector bosons. There is also a scalar boson called the Higgs boson, which gives particles their masses by carrying interactions with the Higgs field. Every type of particle is associated with an antiparticle of the same mass, the opposite charge. Consequently, an uncharged particle is its own antiparticle. Particle-antiparticle pairs can annihilate each other to give energy and get produced again from their energy. Composite particles are called hadrons, consisting of baryons and mesons. Mesons serve to carry the strong force between baryons, like protons and neutrons in atomic nuclei. The theory behind the standard model is the quantum field theory, which includes quantum electrodynamics for electromagnetism, quantum chromodynamics for strong interactions, and quantum flavor dynamics for weak interactions. Why standard model in the first place? Look at this map. Each flight appears quite negligible, yet zooming in and everything becomes more and more significant. Analogously, elementary particles mainly matter at macroscopic scales where their properties can be clearly studied. Planes also cannot fly to wherever they want, but only on certain routes, similar to how elementary particles must follow laws in the standard model. These laws are conservation laws. The standard model has also been applied to studying the history of the universe. Occurrence theories predict the time after the Big Bang when all four fundamental forces were united as one. And as the universe rapidly expanded and cooled down in temperature, this force eventually branched out into the four fundamental forces that we usually observe. However, there is still work to be done, and who knows what we will encounter along the way.